Welcome to VitalityVille, where natural health is home.
My name is Matthew James. I almost died when I was 4 years old, sitting in a crowded kindergarten classroom, my throat closed over from eating contaminated food. This was my first anaphylactic reaction. I developed severe atopic dermatitis all over my body and suffered horribly with it for decades. However, after years of researching natural health, I finally did what no medical doctors could do. I overcame my condition. But some are not so lucky. Some are intentionally harmed and left without recourse. This is what happened with the mysterious and sudden emergence of a brand new disease in 1981, one that has since killed millions of people worldwide, and one for which there is no immediate cure. The disease has come to be known generally as AIDS, or the Acquired Immunodeficiency Syndrome, which is a potentially life-threatening condition likely caused by the Human Immunodeficiency Virus, or HIV. What most do not know is that HIV began as SIV, or SV-40, Simian Immunodeficiency Syndrome, which was transferred from contaminated ground-up monkey kidneys and injected into millions of Africans, including African children. The injection sites for this massive experimental group match up precisely with the first known locations where AIDS was first identified. Edward Hooper's book, The River, explains that between 1957 and 1960, Dr. Hilary Kaprowski led several of the world's first experimental polio prevention campaigns. Essentially, monkey tissue was being used as a biological substratum for polio prevention. However, no screening was done for SV-40 contamination, and it wasn't until 1965 when SV-40 was first identified, and only in 1985 was screening for SIV finally initiated. And this was only after Dr. Albert Sabin found an unidentified non-polio virus in surviving samples of the Kaprowski injectable, which was heralded as a cure for polio, and still is to this day. Now, Edward Hooper's The River stands together with a large body of evidence supporting this horrific idea, including South African scientists Dr. Jennifer Alexander and Dr. Mike Lacasis, independent scholar Louise Pascal, AIDS activist Blaine Ellswood, and William Hamilton, professor of zoology at Oxford University and a world-famous evolutionary biologist. But it wasn't until Tom Curtis published his 1992 article about the topic in Rolling Stone magazine that the theory began to get widespread attention. In fact, lobbying efforts were quickly shut down against the Y-Star Institute in Philadelphia, which Hilary Kaprowski headed, to have samples of the pre-1985 polio injectables examined independently. But as to date, this examination has never been done, and many AIDS scientists argue that the origins of AIDS is not important and that the main thing is to figure out how to stop it. However, this directly and intentionally sidesteps any legal or culpability issues and also ignores what could be learned from the origin, including how to prevent further diseases from cross-species transfers of biological material. So far, the mainstream media has been successful in shutting down discussion. There is one obvious reason for their reluctance. If people came to believe that AIDS came from a contaminated injectable, this would undermine confidence towards the medical pharmacological establishment for the general public, leading to more controls on research and significantly less profit for modern medical corporations. After Curtis's Rolling Stone article was published, Kaprowski sued the magazine, and the injunction shut down media discussion of the topic for many years. Science Magazine refused to publish Curtis's reply to Kaprowski, and later refused to publish Dr. Hamilton's reply as well. Edward Hooper, disgusted at this behavior and wanting to know the truth, quit his job to pursue research for The River and worked for many years full-time on the investigation. He went to the locations and interviewed relatives, obtained records, and explored whether there was any way that a person could have been infected. He focused especially on the case of David Carr, a sailor from Manchester who died in 1959 from what was later diagnosed as AIDS. Hooper interviewed many scientists. He wanted to find out whether the steps in the theory were possible. When did HIV enter the human species? Could SIV survive the processing of polio injection? How exactly was the Kaprowski injectable manufactured? What species of monkey were used? Precisely where was the injectable used and when? Which lots of injectables were given in which parts of Africa? By talking to Kaprowski's collaborators in the 1950s, to their relatives, and to other polio researchers of the same era, Hooper learned more and more details. And the new information did nothing to undermine the polio injectable AIDS theory. It simply helped to fill out an emerging and disturbing picture. One of the arguments used against Hooper's theory is that the SIV, most similar to HIV, is found only in chimpanzees, which were not used in making polio injectables. However, Edward probed into the chimpanzee colony established by Kaprowski in the Congo and found that chimpanzee kidneys had been used and were in fact sent back to the United States. This led Hooper to explore Kaprowski's early research with polio injectables, which were first given to U.S. children with intellectual disabilities, and he obtained some frank admissions from key scientists. To summarize, Hooper's deep investigation into one of humanity's most catastrophic diseases calls into serious question the underlying ethics and intentions of the modern medical industry. And it is entirely possible that Dr. Hilary Kaprowski contributed to the deaths of over 32.7 million people worldwide, while at the same time spawning a new AIDS industry, which as of the end of 2019 is worth $18.6 billion annually. However, as more and more people wake up and catch glimpses of the incontrovertible evidence, they demand to know the truth. And many are turning to natural health and wellness alternatives for genuine and lasting solutions. If you liked this video, please like and subscribe to our channel. And for all of us here at VitalityVille, I'm Matthew James.
Thank you for listening to the VitalityVille podcast.